Do you know the consequences of what you are doing? Claim Caesar as your lord.
I can't. Forgive me, but I... Well, I...
What? What is it?
I'm a follower of Jesus.
Of course. The Messiah. The long-awaited savior. Where's your Messiah now? Let's see him save you from this
witch. Marcus, stop this at once!
But sir, this animal refuses to honor Caesar.
So you decide to punish him with barbaric measures?
But sir, you know the punishment for disloyalty to Caesar.
And what about disloyalty to your commander, huh?
Sir, the High Commander won't let this.
You let me worry about the High Commander. Now go! Are you all right?
Yes, Master.
How did you get yourself in such a predicament, Eli?
I'm sorry, Master. I was on my way to see Jesus, and...
Jesus? Eli, I warned you about how Rome feels about that misguided teacher. Why did you put yourself at such risk? I might not be around next time to see you. You do know the punishment for refusing to honor Caesar, don't you?
Yes, I know. But I, well...
Eli, you're one of my most trusted servants. You have nothing to fear. Speak your mind.
I've become a follower of Jesus. I believe he's the Messiah. He's coming this way, and I was hoping to speak to him about Benjamin.
Benjamin? What about Benjamin? Is there any change?
Sadly, no, Master. I'm sorry. But he is very ill. I know how much you care for him. Truthfully, I don't know how much longer he'll be able to hold on. But that's exactly why I want to see Jesus. Have you heard of the miracles he's been performing? Master, he can help Benjamin.
Eli, I trust your judgment, but really, are you sure this Jesus is all you think he is?
I'm not sure. But what I know is that he speaks with authority. His words are of life, peace, and the kingdom of God.
Peace. Peace. Let's go see this Jesus of yours. If he can heal Benjamin, like you say, perhaps I'll put down my sword and become a believer too. Lead the way.
Thank you.
all my heart, Master. I believe he is the Messiah we've been waiting for. I believe he is the Christ, the Son of God. Master, he can help Benjamin. I know it. Will you speak to him?
What will I say? I don't know.
Think of Benjamin. Jesus can heal him.
Yes. Poor Benjamin. I will speak to Jesus about him. Sir, sir, forgive me. One of my most finest servants lies ill, dying.
Well, then I will come and heal him.
Please, I am not worthy for you to come under my roof. If you could just say the word, he will be healed. I am a man under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to one, go, and he goes. And to another, come, and he comes. And to my servant, do this, and he does it.
Truly, I have not seen this kind of faith in all of Israel. Go, friend. What you have asked for has been done for you because of your faith.
My faith? My faith?
Master! Master! Benjamin, you're healed! Master, I'm healed!
I was in bed in so much pain. Then moments ago, I sat straight up. The fever, it was gone. Master, I ran all this way to find you. It's a miracle. I don't know how or...
I do?
I do as well, I think.
Benjamin, Master spoke to Jesus about you, and he healed you with just a word.
Jesus? I must meet him.
Master, we must go thank him.
Yes, we should. Sir, thank you. For my servant Benjamin, I mean. He is healed. Your ways are strange to me. I don't understand all this, but...
Follow me.
But how can I? I'm Roman. I have loyalties. Responsibilities. Yes, praise him. Master, thank you for speaking to Jesus about me. He asked me to follow him. How could I follow him? I have my duties, my allegiance to Caesar. I'm a Roman soldier. How could I throw 30 years away to follow this Jesus? It would mean suicide for me to bow to someone other than Caesar.
Master, many have sacrificed all to follow him. His disciples gave up their entire lives to go with him.
How could they leave everything to follow a man?
Master, I can tell you more about Jesus as we travel home.
Yes, I want to hear more. Let's go.
Glad to see you changed your mind about punishing this slave. Would you like one of my men to take him somewhere for you? Has this one refused to honor Caesar as well? These Jewish parasites never cease to amaze me.
These men are two of my finest servants. It would do you well to stay out of our way.
I see. No wonder you stopped me from teaching this pest a lesson. You've grown soft to these people. I can't wait to tell the High Commander about this. But first, I must take care of a disturbance near the temple. Seems there is an altercation involving that teacher, Jesus. I look forward to stopping his public disruptions. The Roman way.
Master. Master. We must.
Yes, let's follow them. I don't trust Marcus.
The laws of Moses command that we stone such a woman. What do you say, Nikki? Let anyone among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her. Things today that I have questions about.
Master, you look tired. We should go home. It's been a long and exciting day, and we have a lot to think about.
Yes, let's go. But in the morning, I will seek Jesus out and ask him some questions I have. And Benjamin, we should get you home, although I must admit, you don't look like a man that was dying just a few hours ago.
Nor do I feel like it, sir. Come, let me lead the way.
Such a disturbance to occur right outside your doorstep. Unless you're a sympathizer to their cause.
That's enough! They are not my friends. They are...
Well, it's just that some of us are beginning to wonder where your loyalties lie. To Caesar, or this Christ. Even the High Commander is concerned. Perhaps you're turning soft.
And how would the High Commander know or be concerned with any of this?
Let's just say he has his sources.
I'm a centurion, am I not? My loyalties are none of your business. You are dismissed, and you will not speak of this again. Understood?
Perfectly, sir. Let's just hope Pilate doesn't concern himself with this.
Master, are you all right? he gone?
Yes, Eli. I'm sorry for the jar. I need to get out of here. I need to go somewhere and think to sort all of this out.
Master, I know just the place. A garden just outside the city walls. I will take you there.
Fine. Let's leave right away.
As you wish.
Perfect, Eli. Thank you. Now if you can just...
I won't be far off if you need me, Master.
Have I become soft? 30 years! 30 years I've served the Empire. Caesar is the only god I've been taught to revere. I can't turn my back on Rome. But this Jesus... No one could do the miracles he does without being divine. Could he? How could he be man and God at the same time? None of this makes sense. But his words. I can still hear him saying those words. Follow me. God, can you hear me? I beg you, can you hear me? I'm not the kind of man who prays. How can I follow this Jesus? Can I follow? But can I turn and walk away?
I feel my heart inside. So
Father, please let this cup pass from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done.
He has made himself out to be the Son of God. What's more, he claims to be a king.
What do I know about blasphemy? Or your foolish religion? So you're a king. The king of the Jews? I like it. What would you like me to do with your king?
Crucify him!
This man's done nothing deserving death. You'd have me crucify your king?
We have no king but Caesar.
Crucify him!
Crucify him!
Crucify him! Very well then. But I wash my hands of this man's blood. Centurion, have Jesus whipped and crucified.
But sir, I can't.
What? Are you going against my command? What's your name, soldier?
Anthony, sir.
Ah, yes. I've heard about you. You're the sympathizer. Having a little trouble deciding where your loyalties lie, eh?
No, sir.
the Empire. Very good. And have this man whipped and crucified. And Centurion.
Yes, sir.
You'll be the first to open his back.
As you have commanded.
Take him away!
Do.
I know, Master.
Why, Eli? Why would God let his son die this way? He did no wrong. He harmed no one. And I helped put him to death. But still, as he was dying, I heard him say, "Father, forgive them." How could he forgive me?
I don't know, Master. But God's ways are not our ways, my Lord.
Jesus helped so many. Those people he healed. That woman he forgave. And he helped me. Couldn't he have done more if he was still alive?
I don't have all the answers, Master. But I do know that God is faithful. We just have to believe, even when we don't understand what is happening.
I want to believe. I want to believe.
There are moments on our journey following the Lord, when God illumines every step we take. There are times when circumstances make perfect sense to us as we try to understand each move he makes. But when the path grows dim and our questions have no answers, turn to him. Bow the knee, trust the heart of your Father when the answers go beyond what you can see.
Christ was made. Did he understand the price he paid? Surely.
Seemed to mourn. They took his broken body down.
How do you describe a miracle? Jesus said, tear this temple down and I will raise it up again in 3 days. And that's exactly what happened. The tomb was sealed. I saw to that. But in one victorious moment, the stone was rolled away and Jesus was alive once again. His life, his death, his resurrection changed everything. Changed me most of all. I was a hardened man, set in my ways, committed to a Lord, the wrong Lord. But when Jesus came, everything was different. No longer could I bow to Caesar. No longer could I live a lie when I had encountered the truth. No longer could I bow to anyone other than the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, to Jesus, who is the Christ. To whom will you bow, my friends? To whom will you bow?
And all God's people said,
Amen.
On behalf of the cast and crew of Bow the Knee, we want to thank you this evening for coming out and sharing with us in this most important story in all of our lives. But we do have a few thank yous as well that we need to kick out there. First of all the sets. All the lights, all the sound, the slideshow was under the direction of Joe Young and his crew. So, Joe? Of course, where would we be without all of the music? We had an orchestra, we had a choir, you even joined us a little bit, and you're going to join us again, but all of that under the direction of our musical director, Karen McEver. And a few weeks ago, the artistic director told the crew, just bear with me, it's beautiful in my head. Also responsible for running the crew that put together all the costumes and the whole package as it was put together. So our artistic director, Janice Cilio. But of course, last but certainly not least, we need to give thanks to the Lord our God.
Amen.
Without him, none of this, none of us are possible. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, send us out into this night with your story bubbling up in our hearts. For you have rescued us from our own sinful nature. With your outstretched arms on the cross, when you tell us, I love you this much. As we prepare over the next couple of days to once again experience the empty tomb, your resurrection, the hope for all of our lives, we thank you. I ask you, Lord, to bless each and every individual in this room here tonight. May they have safe travels home. May they celebrate a most holy of Easter. We pray this in the name of the Lamb that was slain, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let's hear it for everybody.
Thank you.
is one.